you'll notice that it is not the team that won the FA Cup at Wembley in May, because there are changes at centre-half, where Peters is in instead of Brown, and at outside right, where we have Seeley instead of Braybrook. But nevertheless, it's the same team that beat Wolverhampton 5-0 here at Upton Park on Monday. Now, moving over to the Tottenham Hotspur team, the first position we look for is right back. There was a grave doubt about whether Cyril Knowles, their new fullback, would be able to play, but he passed a fitness test before the match, and Bill Nicholson said he's okay, so he goes into the side, and not Peter Baker. The referee from Sheffield, George McCabe, one of the best in the business, just checks his watches, and West Ham kick off against Tottenham Hotspur. So much talent on the field today. This should be a sparkling game, because matches between these two clubs often produce a lot of goals. And here comes young Sissons. And now a chance for West Ham in the closing opening seconds. And a fine save by Jennings. He can be hurt. I think he got a boot on his hand. A very fine, daring save by Pat Jennings, the Irish international goalkeeper. Spurn, the West Ham centre forward. Chasing up with him is Norman, urging his men forward, urging his men forward. Mallory, finding Dyson. It's Greaves. Hands by. Look, they are quite right. Spurs were in possession. Sensible bit of refereeing there. Henry finding Jones. Assistance. Clouds of dust rising now and then as the players turn quickly, shows how dry the ground is. This is Hurst. Oh, beautiful ball to Byrne. He scored. Hurst. Oh, that's a critical shot. And Jennings caught unawares, I think. Oh, what a bad goal kick. Obviously, there was no foul there unless you're a West Ham supporter. Byrne had to move quickly and obviously fell over Norman. And throw to West Ham. It'll be time any second. Bobbington getting that ball through to Moore. Now to Hurst. Moore again. Another careless one. Huh? Reeves so far been shut out of this game. Taking control. Referee has got his watch in his hand. And there's the whistle for half-time, with West Ham United leading Tottenham 1-0. Jones, then Saul, the fair-haired one, actually red hair, and Greaves. And it's Spurs who start the second half. That's Greaves, frankly. Up through and is rather a a terrible story. We just heard from the press box, none of the Tottenham players know it, about Dave Mackay having been carried off in a reserve match, having broken the leg again, the same leg as he broke at Manchester United. So that's a bit of sad news for Spurs. It's unconfirmed, of course. Now here's Burkett for West Ham. hoist to Burn. Offside given against Robertson. Up with Moore. Now Hurst. Back to Boyce. 10 minutes of the second half gone. No, West Ham leading 1-0. Spurs on top now, and it's Jones. To Robertson. After 56 minutes. There's Greaves just behind him, is Bovington. There's Bovington. That's Hurst. West Ham crowding a little too much in the middle now. Oh, it's a beautiful through ball. To take it. Score 1-1. Beautiful goal by Greaves. Beautifully taken penalty. Minutes at the second half gone, and Jimmy Greaves has put Spurs into a 2-1 lead. Well, there's two goal Jimmy Greaves, and West Ham have really been knocked off their perch by this tremendous second half rally of Tottenham's. Tottenham with much the better side in this second half. Jones, Greaves. To West Ham, now into Boyce. Seeley to Boyce. Penalty! Penalty! A blatant push in the back. No argument about that at all. There couldn't be any argument about that. No, pushed in the back. Seeley in the back. So, a minute after Spurs have gone into a 2-1 lead with a penalty, West Ham have the chance to draw level with a penalty. I just can't see on what Spurs are basing their appeals against this decision. So Byrne, who got the first for West Ham, is taking the penalty. The chance to be a two-goal man, just like Jimmy Greaves has become. What tension there is now. Dead visit. He has got Boyce to take it. Boyce has now moved up as an all-out attacker. Usually he's a midfield player. This is Boyce. Up goes Byrne. A beautiful goal! Talk and argue about this game all week in the pubs, clubs, North and in East London. Rees back to Knowles. He's going to give it a crack. Now he's got the loose shin pads. Roll his stockings down. Solemn pacing of 10 yards. Sissons in Mills Hurst. Sun bothering the players now, anything can happen. And Knowles to Greaves. Moore, is it over? No, it isn't over. A lovely clearance through to Hurst. Boyce taking over, back to Sissons. To Moore, who comes pounding up. Now Boyce, and this is Sissons. Henry sensibly giving away a corner. Now that surely everyone's going to pound up for this one. Moore is up there, and in the penalty area though. Seeley with the corner for West Ham. Hurst. Hearted in the West Ham fans, whistling as if they want the referee to blow the final whistle. And the final whistle's gone. And this splendid, fine, exciting game of football has been won by West Ham United. 3-2 of a very gallant losers in Tottenham Hotspur.